Hachette Audio presents Baseball Road Trips, the complete guide to all the ballparks, with beer, bites, and sights nearby. Written by Timothy Malcolm, read by George Newbern. As you listen to this audiobook, please note that whenever you hear sounds such as this, it means you can refer to the accompanying PDF for additional information such as maps, photos, nearby attractions, and other useful resources that will help turn your baseball road trip into an unforgettable experience. Play ball. Baseball was first coined the national pastime by the New York Mercury way back in 1856, 20 years before the founding of the National League. Amazingly, the term continues to be used today, although it doesn't hold quite the same water as it once did, with football and basketball also jockeying for attention from sports writers and television viewers. Whether or not it lives up to its original nickname is a matter of opinion, but baseball remains as exciting as ever. Just watch the otherworldly Fernando Tatis Jr. connect with a pitch in the zone. The meteoric Mike Trout run down a curving fly ball, and the dazzling Garrett Cole dial up an unhittable heater. You can lose yourself in the beauty of these phenomenal feats of athleticism. Baseball fans will often tell you that with each game you watch, you're bound to see something you've never seen before. Hundreds of pitches are thrown, home runs are launched, outstanding defensive plays are made, and sometimes the ball moves in a way that baffles the batter, the umpire, the fans, and everyone watching at home. With every game we see, baseball offers us another reason to appreciate the uniqueness of human achievement. Baseball is also a lens we can use to view America, to see its flaws as well as its ideals. The history of the game includes decades of segregation, systemic racism that lives on in everything from the way players are discussed to the stadium deals that take access away from underserved populations. Then there are the nicknames and chants that appropriate and offend indigenous cultures. Even while we as fans acknowledge these problems and push owners, managers, players, and fellow fans to do better, we can still love baseball for the game itself. Even as we confront these realities, we can see that although baseball is messy and flawed, it can also instill sheer joy. Hop in the car and chase that joy. It can be found in all of the parks, from jewel box legends like Fenway and Wrigley to the most modern and corporatized venues like Truist Park and Globe Life Field. See the sports landmarks along the way and learn its story from every angle. You'll also see the country at its rawest. History, both frozen in time and unfolding before your eyes. Sit in a ballpark with the sunshine beaming down and a cold beer in your hand. You'll lose yourself in something incredible, something beautiful, something you've never seen before and may never quite see the same way again. To appreciate baseball is to indulge in America. Enjoy the game. Top 10 Ballparks. 1. Soak it all in at Wrigley Field in Chicago. This quirky stadium and its defining features, the ivy-covered brick outfield wall, the old-school scoreboard, the W flag that proudly waves when the Cubs win, invite you to celebrate baseball at its most iconic. 2. Get goosebumps at Fenway Park in Boston. Fenway is the most fascinating venue in baseball, with the green monster, the sharp angles of the outfield, pesky's pole in right field, and a block party on Jersey Street every game day. 3. Eat, drink, and celebrate Giants history at Oracle Park in San Francisco. Indulge in the famed garlic fries and sip local craft beer at this ballpark that pays homage to a team with deep roots and larger-than-life legends. 4. Celebrate the beauty of baseball at Dodger Stadium in Los Angeles. The stadium's architecture plays with angles and waves, both contrasting with and mimicking the rolling hills beyond the outfield. The bleachers are clean and cool, the blue fence pops just enough, and those uniforms are crisp as all get out. This ballpark is where baseball looks its best. 5. Revel in the retro classic feel of Oriole Park at Camden Yards in Baltimore. This stadium was the first to be designed in the retro classic style, drawing inspiration from early 20th century ballparks, but with a sleek, modern twist. 6. Gawk at the view at PNC Park in Pittsburgh. Walk across the Roberto Clemente Bridge to arrive at the stadium, then scope the view from home plate, and you'll get it right away. This is the best setting for a baseball game. 7. Bask in the San Diego sun at Petco Park. You're sure to have good weather, ideal for taking in a game, eating delicious local bites, and drinking a good craft beer or two. 8. Witness the future of baseball at T-Mobile Park in Seattle. With a food program curated by a James Beard Award winner, a beer selection that's brimming with unique brews, and multiple kid-friendly areas, this stadium offers one of the best modern game day experiences. 9. Join in the fun at Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. This deceptively small retro classic venue has a whole lot going in its favor. The food and drink options highlight a wealth of local street foods. The outfield midway of Ashburn Alley is a great spot for pregame fun, and the sight lines are among the best in baseball. 10. Enjoy a little bit of everything at Target Field in Minneapolis. This ballpark lets you sample everything that baseball has to offer, all in one place. A field with kooky angles, fun nods to franchise history, open-air spaces for socializing, stellar food and drink, plentiful parking, and easy access via public transit. Best baseball attractions and events. National Baseball Hall of Fame and a Museum, Cooperstown, New York. The National Baseball Hall of Fame and Museum is a dreamland offering days of excitement and enrichment. The climax is the Hall of Fame gallery, where you can read the plaque of every single inductee. Nearby, Doubleday Field lures folks to sit and wonder in the grandstand. Add the magic of Main Street Cooperstown and some really good local beer, and you've got a perfect long weekend. It's a little off the beaten path, but nonetheless essential. You may want to visit before or after going to Boston. Negro Leagues Baseball Museum, Kansas City, Missouri. At the must-visit Negro Leagues Baseball Museum, you'll learn all about gifted players like Satchel Paige, Buck Leonard, Josh Gibson, Cool Papa Bell, Jackie Robinson, and Hank Aaron. The highlight is a replica ball field that's home to statues of the absolute greats. Field of Dreams, Dyersville, Iowa. The Field of Dreams has become a showplace for exhibition and special regular season games, but it came to fame as the place where the beloved movie of the same name was shot. There seems to be some spirit in the sky out here where a baseball field was cut into farmland. Experience it for yourself. Walk or play on the field, or even watch a game. Babe Ruth Birthplace and Museum, Baltimore, Maryland. At the Babe Ruth Birthplace and Museum, you can visit the house where the mighty George Herman Ruth was raised and take a tour through his life, learning more about his childhood, the famed called shot in the 1932 World Series, and his massive influence on baseball. National Ballpark Museum, Denver, Colorado. Just up the street from Coors Field, the under-the-radar National Ballpark Museum has artifacts from multiple jewel box parks, including a chunk of Fenway Park's Green Monster, chairs from former stadiums, and all sorts of game-worn jerseys. Opening day, late March or early April, Cincinnati. The Reds open each year at their home park. Accompanying that event is the pregame Fenway Market Parade, which has been going on for more than 100 years. Typically, a former Red or other notable baseball figure serves as Grand Marshal. Jackie Robinson Day, April 15th, league-wide. To commemorate the day Jackie Robinson made his Major League debut and broke the color line, all of Major League Baseball honors him by having an on-field personnel wear Robinson's jersey number 42. Patriots Day, third Monday in April, Boston. This day marks the earliest battles of the American.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.